Welcome you all to the next lecture in our anthropology series. So we had started human growth and development, and therein we had talked about the prenatal phase, the postnatal phase, and in postnatal we had done infancy. We had started childhood, in which we had done the early childhood, from that you can say from 3 years to 6 years. We had talked about its motor skills, the cognitive skills that were developed, and one thing you can also add in there is the development of language skills. Okay, so you can just add the one more point in there, development of language. So in that time, as we had seen the hand-eye coordination, we had talked about their writing skills, their walking, how they can walk, they can cut with scissors, their body growth and all of that. But development of language also you can talk about. So now they can name familiar things like their pets, body parts. Okay, na? They can use tenses. Now the use of tenses also start. So now they make better sentences, right? They can use the words, differentiate kar sakte hain I, you, we ke beech mein. So this differentiation starts to happen from the monosyllable syllabic, jaise ki ma, pa. These are the first words that the baby can learn. To now he can say complex words. Jaise ki complex words, cha-cha, right? All of this. And then it starts to make sentences also in the early childhood. Theek hai? By the time baby becomes from 5 to 6 years, he can make very complex sentences. He can use the, you can say prepositions, conjunctions, all of that. So, abhi complex sentences banane lagta hai. Theek hai? So, he can make complex sentences now. Okay, so this point also you can just add in there. So this picture you should see. This picture shows how the development of different parts happen. So we had talked about by the year 2 years the brain development takes place. Okay, so ye dekho, by 2 years he has achieved like 75% of his adult brain weight. So 75 to 80% he has already achieved in his 2 years ka time. Okay, so this is one thing. Then you can see how the reproductive thing happens. So reproduction only starts around 13 years. Okay, so reproductive aapki growth happens after 13 years. General body growth also happens like that only. Aapki 30-40% growth ho jati hai by the year 4 years. Theek hai? Then it becomes very slow till 12 years. So jo humne bola tha childhood mein, we had talked about it yesterday, right? That childhood mein that stagnation or that development and growth becomes very slow. So you can see if I rub this all, you can see that by 4 years to 12 years, that growth has only this much, has only been this much. So you can say it has only been 40 to 50%. So only 10% growth and development has happened in so many years. And uske baad it takes a jump. Theek hai? Similarly, the lymph. Theek hai? Aise karke you can just have a little bit idea about this picture also. So now let's go to our middle childhood. So when there is the middle childhood, you can say this is the time roughly from 6 to 12 years. Theek hai? So and if you don't have to write because humne late childhood bhi karna hai, so you just write it 6 to 9 years. And then come the late childhood also. Theek hai na? So in this period, the growth stage is supposed to be the most stable period, as we have seen that zyada there is no much changes that happen, but there is differential rate of growth in different body parts. Theek hai na? For example, your height starts to grow more. Theek hai? And there is different body parts develop at different rates, but stable hai. Not much growth and development, remarkable shift nahi hota hai. Like we were seeing in the in the prenatal phase, in infancy, the child was growing very rapidly. Even not in size, but in motor development also, skills also. Okay, that starts to slow down. With the acquisition of proficiency in locomotion, child is able to walk like adults. So by the age of 7 years, they can walk like adults. And this period is also called the mid growth spurt. So abhi growth spurt hota hai, that period of time when the growth is accelerated and it happens at a very fast rate. So ek aisa growth spurt is the adolescent growth spurt. So that is very, very remarkable growth spurt. Uske alawa, if you have to talk about early childhood, matlab ek childhood growth spurt bhi ho sakta hai, jo abhi hum ye middle childhood mein we are doing, that there is a middle childhood growth spurt. But this is not that remarkable as the adolescent one, which we are going to study in the next lecture. So in the mid growth spurt, a short term acceleration in height and weight is experienced. Theek hai? So ek height and weight increases, but not in exceptional way, very, very steadily it increases. Theek hai? Before the onset of the adolescent growth spurt. So iske baad, very important, adolescent growth spurt will come. So this middle growth spurt occurs usually between 6.5 to 8.5 years. Theek hai? Replacement of milk teeth by permanent teeth. We had seen that in infancy, the by 3 years the mouth was full, around 20 teeth they were milk teeth, but now replacement of milk teeth with the permanent teeth starts to happen. Then comes your late childhood. Okay, it is influenced by growth of sex hormones. So this can also be called as pre-pubertal stage. So this is 9 to 12 years, you can say. Or if you have to say, you can just say 10 to 12 years. Okay? So this is pre-pubertal stage and your growth of sex hormone starts. Okay? It marks the beginning of adolescent growth spurt. So adolescent growth spurt starts. Sexual dimorphism in body size and proportion during the pre-pubertal stage. Now what is sexual dimorphism? Very important term. Sexual dimorphism. Very important. What does this mean? Now it means that sexual differences starts to show. When you see the small children, okay, you cannot make very remarkable differences between boys and girls. They have similar voices. The breast development in the girls has not yet happened, right? But now, when this pre-pubertal, or you can say childhood growth spurt, okay, which will lead to the adolescent growth spurt, this time there are marked sexual dimorphism or marked sexual differences. That means breast development hone lagega among girls, there'll be beard, that boys will start to get beard. Theek hai? The testosterone level starts to increase, so voice of the boys get deepened. Theek hai? Girls ka hip region starts to become more fat starts to accumulate. Girls starts to get their menstruation. Boys get a lot of acne during this period. Even the girls can get. So what is this? This is the time when the difference starts to get marked in boys and girls. Okay? They starts to understand complex abstract concepts. Okay? Unki reading, writing skills, speech skills better ho jate hain. Now they can speak very clearly, fluently, fast, okay, all of that. So these are the indicators that show physically dependent child is moving towards independence. So now the child becomes more not dependent on the parents and starts to take out independent activities. So now if we have to sum up the childhood period, we had already done about the early childhood. So I'll just summarize the middle and late childhood under one head only. Okay, so this is the time we are talking about from 6 to 12 years. Okay, that is the first point. Then comes at this time till we reach the age of 10 years, girls are longer than boys. Okay, because maine bola tha, there are sex related differences also. So girls till 10 years are longer than boys, but after that, boys start to catch up. And then after 14 years and 15 years, after the, you can say, the adolescent growth spurt, boys become taller than girls and heavier than girls and bade ho jate, they overtake girls. Theek hai? So this is one point that you have to remember. And this growth also will depend, as we have talked about, it will depend upon the race, it will depend upon the sex. So there are sex related changes also. Socioeconomic condition, which includes your nutrition, your family background, your genetics. Theek hai? It also depends upon your genetics. So, if somebody has taller parents, he will have a taller child also. Language kafi clear ho jati hai. Motor development bahut zyada ho jati hai. Theek hai? All of this is there. So, I hope there is no doubt, and we have completed. Tomorrow, we'll start with the adolescent period, the most important phase in the growth and development of a human. Okay? So, I hope you guys are liking the lectures. If you are, guys, please do like, share and subscribe. And thank you so much.